When we hear climate change, that's way more academic for us. Since we have a lot on our plates, we don't have time to worry about climate change.
Welcome to the other side of the country. You can see the inequality that is happening. These people that are contributing to the climate change, but they least being affected by it. You can see where we took other footages. There are shacks, there are rusty roads, there are floods, there are wetlands. You can even fit more than a township in their houses.
Ekwakabantu kuthwa iwetland lesihleli kuyo. Kodwa ke asinayo ichoice. Ngoba asinayo enye indawo yohlala. Sihlala apha kule ndawo iwetland ngoba asinayo imali yorenta. Siyacela ke kubantu abangaphambili de basihoye.
So if sizosuka apha, we don't know where we gonna go to. So it's our place, it's our home.
I'm struggling to get food, to get shelter. These things are the necessities. But because of the service delivery, we don't get those things. So if you're gonna talk about climate change, do you expect me to worry about climate change? When I listen, I only hear the destruction, moving cars, drillers drilling. The realities hit hard on me. The land is crying. It's bleeding blood in the form of water, fires burning, seeking attention by destroying the nature. Is there anyone hears the cry of this land? The universe is confused. Is this a movie or a reality? Who is this destroyer? Aren't you ashamed of yourself about this? Are you the one who's responsible for this crisis? Listening to the land.
Hello guys, my name is Asavela Masheba from Emfuleni here in Western Cape, and I'm part of Uvuno Hub. And for me, this whole project of climate change, it has been more of gaining more information because I didn't care much about climate change. So gaining such information about wetlands and climate change has been so great for me. Thank you, Taseda.
Hello, my name is Sandile Fanana, the Empire, the Poet. I'm from Eastern Cape here in South Africa, and I'm living in Western Cape. In Cape Town, I'm staying in Vryheid. I'm part of Uvuno Hub. This experience was phenomenal, I would say, because I didn't know anything about climate change until I worked in it and did some research, and we spoke to the scientists who gave us the insight of what is living in the wetlands, as I'm part of the people that are living in the shacks in Overcome Heights.
We are Uvuno Hub!
Thina apha eKapa sine-companies ezinkulu yabo ezikhipha umsi, ezinjengoba zikhipha umsi zidamage ozone layer, which is like ozone layer yenza ke ngoku ukuthi kube khona izinto ezitshintshayo. And then ke ngoku thina sihlala nabantu abanazo nesifuba yabo. And ke ngoku vele indawo yethu nayo indawo ngathi ngumhlaba omanzi ne. Like yabona nje uma ngoku uzawungenisa ukuba khona iingcungcuni ziyangena lapha ezindlini zihlala apha phezulu, then xa kucinyiwe yho ziba yiloo nto because kumanzi.
Stay tuned and be here at this place. It's a sewage station.
Imikhukhulena akuyondawo ehlaliseka kamnandi. Qha ke sihleli ngoba sizawuthini sizawuyaphi. And xa kunetha imvula le mikhukhu iyanetha. Enye into ndithi kukho le surish elapha. Inuka la surish apha phakathi endlini. And again, nempilo esiyiphilayo apha thina bantu. Abantu ndithi basebenzise ezipotyipotyi zakhona. Kuyachithwa nje, kuyanuka nje kule ndawo. Kangoba nasezinzulwini zobusuku uthi ulele nje nouve ivumba. Kangoba andimandi na ukulala ngemaski yam. Ndiyithathe nje ndiyifake ndiyivale. Ngoba ngoku ayikho into endingayenza.
The reason we're here at the moment is to try and understand how climate change affects us in our everyday lives. And you can see there is water treatment plant just on my left. We've got a municipal dumping site on my right. So a whole lot of different people that live in these spaces. So in Cape Town, how we experience that is lots and lots of floods and how that destroys properties. And there are all sorts of problems with water, especially coming from a treatment plant and impacts on human health. Then you'll probably see an increase loss of waterborne diseases. It's up to everybody to work towards trying to find solutions for that.
So when people move onto a wetland, it's not out of choice, but these areas are often the only unused space available for people moving to the city in hopes of making a living. And the tragic thing is that these spaces may seem livable in the summer. Houses are flooded. People are forced to find elsewhere to live in an area where decent land is already hard to come by. So people establish themselves there. And when winter rains come, we then start to see problems related to human health. When people don't get help in terms of being removed and taken somewhere safe, what are the dangers they face being there in the wetland? So the dangers are related to human health, as well as a precarious and uncertain living conditions. How can someone thrive when their feet are wading in water in their own home? In terms of inequality, is it fair for people who are poor to suffer the consequences of rich people? Of course, this is wholly unjust, as the, you know, the people who suffer the most from global crises, such as climate change, very often contribute the least. Many of our global problems stem from unsustainable extraction and consumption of resources. And generally speaking, the more affluent a society is, the more resources it consumes. And the consequences of this are most often felt by poorer communities who are not buffered against the negative effects of climate change. Yes.
No stress, but you can't motorcycle. Listening to the land. When I listen, I only hear the destruction of moving cars. Drillers drilling. Is this the kind of life I should be living? The realities hit hard on me. Is there anyone to rescue me from this hole? Is there anyone listening? Is it only you, land? The land is crying. It's bleeding blood in the form of water. Fires burning, seeking attention by destroying the nature. The universe is confused. Is it a movie or a reality? Is there anyone who can hear the cry of this land? Is there anyone listening? Who is this destroyer? Aren't you ashamed of yourself about this? Are you the one responsible for this crisis? Listen, listen, listen to the land.